हाय फ्रेंड्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन एंड आई वेलकम यू वंस अगेन. एंड इन दिस आवर डायमेंशनलेस नंबर सीरीज, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस प्रांटल नंबर. इट इज़ आवर सेकेंड नंबर एंड इट इज़ रिलेटेड टू द हीट ट्रांसफर. एंड दिस नंबर वॉज गिवन बाय जर्मन फिजिसिस्ट लुडविग प्रांट. फ्रॉम द डेफिनेशन ऑफ प्रांटल नंबर, वी नो दैट प्रांटल नंबर इज डिफाइंड एज द रेशियो ऑफ मोमेंटम डिफ्यूजिबिलिटी to the thermal diffusivity, but we don't have any idea about momentum diffusivity and heat diffusivity. First we will discuss what is the physical significance of momentum diffusivity, heat diffusivity, and then we will proceed for the physical significance of Prandtl number. Here I want to discuss with you one more thing, that we have two types of properties. One is system properties and second is cell properties. Here we have three system properties: mass diffusivity, momentum diffusivity, and thermal diffusivity or heat diffusivity. All these three system properties have the same unit, and that is meter square per second. Please remember this. And cell properties are like that: thermal conductivity of a material, dynamic viscosity of a fluid. All these properties are cell properties. Is it clear? Here we will discuss what we mean by momentum diffusion and thermal diffusivity. First we are going to discuss momentum diffusion. Momentum diffusion is the ability of a fluid to transport momentum, and it is caused by shear stress in liquid, which causes a random motion of the molecules. Now we will discuss thermal diffusion or thermal diffusivity. Thermal, as we know that thermal diffusivity is defined as the ratio of heat conducted to the heat stored, heat energy stored per unit volume of the material. Again, thermal diffusivity has the same unit, meter square per second. And what is the its significance? It describes how fast heat can be transferred across the medium. And as we know that greater the value of thermal diffusivity, faster is the propagation of the heat through the medium. And one more thing in which we confuse, there are two different things. One is thermal diffusivity and second one is thermal conductivity. Both are different type of concepts and we will cover in our heat transfer videos. So please don't be confused in those two concepts also. Now we will derive the formula of Prandtl number. As we know that Prandtl number is equal to momentum diffusivity by thermal diffusivity, and momentum diffusivity is nothing but kinematic viscosity. So we can write simple kinematic viscosity is mu by rho, and to the thermal diffusivity, that is k by rho Cp. Rho and rho will cancel out and we will get Cp mu by k. And most of us mugged up this formula, that Prandtl number is equal to Cp mu by k. Now where we will discuss each and every term, where what is mu? Mu is dynamic viscosity, having a unit of Pascal second or Newton second per meter square. Rho is the density, K is the thermal conductivity, having a unit of watt per meter per Kelvin. Again, rho is the density and Cp is the specific heat or fluid specific heat capacity, having a unit of joule per kg per Kelvin. Please remember all these terms. So we can say that Prandtl number is equal to Cp mu by K. Now here we will discuss the physical significance of the Prandtl number. As we know that we have different types of physical significance, we will cover basically only two physical significance. First one is that Prandtl number signifies the thickness of the thermal boundary layer and the thickness of the hydrodynamic boundary layer or velocity boundary layer. And second one is that it tells us how fast the thermal diffusion takes place in comparison to the momentum diffusion. Or we can say our first line in simple layman language, that it tells us the relative thickness of the thermal boundary layer to the momentum boundary layer. As we know that from this formula, del by del t is equal to Prandtl to the power 1/3, where del is equal to del hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness and del t is equal to thermal boundary layer thickness, where PR is Prandtl number to the power 1/3. Now there are three different cases which are possible: maybe Prandtl number greater than 1, maybe Prandtl number less than 1, or Prandtl number is equal to 1. So we are going to explain one case and remaining automatically you will understand. First, we are going to discuss case first in which Prandtl number is greater than 1. If the value of Prandtl number is greater than 1, then simple, we can say momentum diffusivity greater than thermal diffusivity, or simple hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness greater than thermal boundary layer thickness. As we know that as velocity or hydrodynamic boundary layer is thicker than the thermal boundary layer, which means that the given fluid has the ability to transport the momentum faster through the fluid as compared to the heat transfer by conduction, or simple we can say that convection dominates over the conduction, or we can explain it in one other different form, that is, if momentum diffusivity is higher than thermal diffusivity, then the distance which a fluid will take to fully develop the velocity boundary layer is less as compared to the distance taken for the thermal boundary layer to fully develop. In similar way, we can explain for other different cases also. If Prandtl number is less than 1 and Prandtl number is equal to 1, in case of Prandtl number equal to 1, both the boundary layer thickness will have the same value. In second case, we can say that if value of Prandtl number is less than 1, if value of Prandtl number is less than 1, then also we can simply say that thermal diffusivity dominate. This means that conduction dominates over convection. And one more significance of Prandtl number is that, or this relation, Prandtl number is significant because it can be used to determine the thermal conductivity of gases at high temperature, where it is difficult to measure experimentally. Now in this slide, we will discuss the value of Prandtl numbers and range. For gases, the value of Prandtl number range is 0.721. For water, 1 to 10. In some books, it is also mentioned 1 to 14. But we are going to take in a simple general way so that you will have an idea, because in any PSU, they asked a simple question that the value of water for Prandtl number at this temperature, and answer was nearly 7 point something. Third one is liquid metals. For liquid metals, its range is 0.001 to 0.03. And for oils, 50 to 1 lakh or 50 to 2 lakh also. This data varies. With the help of the value of or the range of the Prandtl number, we can conclude some important point also. One simple point is that, and all these things are very important for your interview point of view, that heat diffuses very quickly in liquid metals because Prandtl number is less than 1, and very slowly in oils because Prandtl number is greater than 1 relative to momentum. And we can also say consequently thermal boundary layer is much thicker for liquid metals and much thinner for oils relative to the velocity boundary layer. Please remember all these important points. Here we will discuss one advanced concept of related to the Prandtl number, that is effective Prandtl number, or simple we can say that laminar Prandtl number and turbulent Prandtl number. Laminar Prandtl number and turbulent Prandtl number. When dealing with Prandtl numbers, we have to define a laminar part of a Prandtl number and a turbulent part of a Prandtl number. Up to this point, we have discussed an equation of Prandtl number, that was Prandtl number is equal to this by this. This equation is valid only and only for laminar flow. Please remember this. Now we are going to deal with the effective Prandtl number. Effective Prandtl number equation is effective Prandtl number, that should be equal to kinematic viscosity by thermal diffusivity plus kinematic turbulent viscosity to the turbulent thermal diffusivity. And the turbulent Prandtl number is also a non-dimensional term, which is defined as the ratio between the momentum at the diffusivity to the heat transfer at the diffusivity. And it simply describes mixing of rotation of fluids. And one more thing, please remember, the simplest model for Prandtl number for turbulent flow is the Reynolds analogy, which yields a turbulent Prandtl number of 1. So we can say that in the special case where the Prandtl number and the turbulent Prandtl number both equal to वन एंड दिस इज द केस ऑफ इन द रेनॉल्ड्स एनालॉजी वेयर द वेलोसिटी प्रोफाइल एंड द टेम्परेचर प्रोफाइल्स आर आइडेंटिकल. आई होप यू विल एंजॉय दिस वीडियो एंड थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग. थैंक यू वेरी मच.